Hello and welcome to my channel Biology Tutorials by NHJ. I welcome all my dear students, colleagues, friends and family and also who is watching this tutorial. In this tutorial we are going to study about an introduction about biology and some basic information about syllabus that given by Bhaktakavi Narasimha Mehta University. So before we are starting, I am giving the brief introduction about myself. I am Nidhi Joshi from Junagadh, Gujarat. I completed my Bachelor of Science from Saurashtra University and I also completed my Master of Science from Saurashtra University. My specialization subject is zoology. So now we are starting to get into the topic. We are starting from the very beginning and very much basic information so we can clear out your mindset about the subject biology. First of all, the bigger question arise in our mind is, what is biology? What is biology? It is a branch of science. Yes, it is a branch of science. There are main three branch of science like chemistry, physics and biology. Chemistry that deals with the chemical science, physics that deals with the physical science, and the biology is the deal. Biology is deals with the biological science. Is it right answer? Biology is a branch of science. Let's find it. Have you ever wondered about the universe? Which parts they made up of? It is made up of many things like stars, galaxies, asteroids, planets and subplanets. Planets like Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Uranus, Neptune. These all planets are in one solar system as we all know. And the main power is the sun and the biggest star. Besides these, we all are living on the planet Earth. Here we can see the biggest star, sun, the galaxy, Mercury, Earth, Mars, Venus, Saturn, Jupiter, some asteroids here. As we all know that we are living on the planet Earth, then what is the fascinating about the planet Earth? Where we belong to? What is the fascinating about the planet Earth? Where we belong to? Think about it. And the answer is, life is on the planet Earth. So, there are many kinds of living organisms lives on the planet Earth, like plants that are autotrophs and makes energy from the sun. Animals, they are also living organisms, but they are heterotrophed in nutrition. So they are for food, they are belonging for food for other animals. Microorganisms, humans, birds, insects, etc. There are many animals like this picture. There are also elephants like bigger mammals. There are butterfly like small insects. They are well evolved animal on Earth. They are human beings, and not in the least, but the plants, they are autotrophs. They are autotrophs that they can produce their own food on the presence of light, sunlight. So the biology means, so study of all these living organisms together makes easy. We all are need to learn biology. So biology means the study of life. The term biology is arrived from Greek word. There are two Greek words combining, bio or logos. Bios means life and logos means to study. That the answer of our first question, what is biology, is the study of life. Biology, there are many definitions. It gives biology is a branch of science that deals with the living organism. The study of living organism is collectively called biology. Now, how can we forget who give us this important and precious subject to us? The Greek philosopher Aristotle, the father of biology, known the father of biology is Aristotle. There are many branches, there are further many branches of biology on the basis of kinds of which kind of organisms they have. Second, on the basis of special group of organisms they have, and on the basis of approaching of study. In next, we are studying about branches of biology. First, on the basis of kinds of organism, botany, zoology, and microbiology. These are the main three branches of biology. Botany includes plants, zoology branch includes animals, and microbiology, it includes microorganism. Further, on the basis of special group of organisms, bacteriology, virology, mycology, entomology, ichthyology, herpetology, ornithology, etc. Bacteriology that deals with bacteria, virology that deals with viruses, mycology that deals with fungus, entomology that deals with the insects, ichthyology that deals with fishes, herpetology that deals with the herpetofauna, and ornithology that deals and study of avian birds. On third branch, on the basis of approaching of study, anatomy, morphology, histology, cytology, physiology, embryology, taxonomy, ecology, genetics, biochemistry, biostatistics, evolution, pathology, immunology, etc. These all are the branches of biology that we study. But besides these, there are main three branches like zoology, botany, and microbiology we are further studying. There is main three branches of biology. Botany, it deals with the plant science. Father of botany is none other than Theophrastus. He is the student of Aristotle and also the Greek philosopher. The second branch of biology is zoology. It deals with the animals. The father of zoology is Aristotle. He is also the Greek philosopher and he is also known as the father of biology. Microbiology, it deals with the microorganisms that they are decomposers. And the father of microbiology is Antony Leeuwenhoek. Antony Leeuwenhoek was the Dutch scientist and Dutch businessman, and he is also known as the first microscopist and first microbiologist. Now, further question is arise in our mind is, what is zoology? It comes from the Latin word zoologia to English word zoology. It combines two words, zoo plus logos. Zoo, it means animals. Logos means to study. So collectively, it is called the study of animal is called zoology. It deals with animals. In scientific manner, we are defined the term zoology is it is the branch of biology that studies the animal kingdom, including the structure of animal, morphology, physiology, embryology, evolution, classification, their habit and habitats, and distribution of all the animals, both living and the extinct animals, and how they are interacting with their ecosystem. It is collectively called the term zoology. It includes many creatures, many living organisms like human beings, insects like spiders, butterflies, moths, mammals like elephant, cat, dog, lions, birds like crow, pigeon, fowls, fishes like chondrichthyes, osteichthyes, and worms like earthworm and platyhelminths and escalmens. For all these animal study, we need to learn and we need to study zoology. And the basis of zoology is systematics. In further session and further tutorial, we are studying about systematics. Now we are discussing about the syllabus that given. Now we are further discussing about the syllabus that given by the Bhaktakavi Narasimha Mehta University for the semester 3 students. In semester 3, SYBS Zoology, Zoology paper Z03, in this paper, you all have to study non-chordates animals. In these, systematics, forms and functions, cell biology, histology, animal behavior, and economic zoology, wildlife biology, ecology, and instrumental biology, you have to study it. We are further discussing the topics, the units of your syllabus. In unit 1, you have to study cell and feature and classification of two classes in non-chordates animal, structural organization in different phylum of non-chordates with example. The phylums are Protozoa, Porifera, Coelenterata or Cnidaria, Platyhelminthes, Ascalminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata and Chordata. The second unit is forms and functions in animal. The second unit is subdivided into three subunits. In subunit 2.1, you have to study about Porifera, general account of canal system in sponges and economic importance of sponges. In subunit 2.2, general structure and morphology with functional anatomy of a following type. The phylum is Annelida and the type study of leech, Hirudinaria granulosa. In these subunit, you have to study about classification, external feature, body wall, digestive system, nervous system, hemosylomic system, excretion and reproductive system, and development, locomotion, and respiration of leech. In subunit 2.3, Arthropoda phylum is here. In these part pair, you have to study about peripeters is a connecting link between Annelida and Arthropoda. Different types of mouth parts that found in insects. First is chewing and biting type of mouth part that found in cockroach. Chewing and lapping type of mouth part found in honeybee. Piercing and sucking type of mouth part found in mosquito. Sponging type of mouth part found in housefly. And siphoning type of mouth parts found in butterfly. In unit 3, you have to study about cell biology and histology. There are further division of subunits 3.1 and 3.2. 3.1 is cell biology. In this unit, you have to study only structure and functions about the cellular organelles. It is comparatively and it is collectively called cell biology. First one is Golgi complex, second one is ribosome, third one is lysosome organelles, fourth one is centrioles and basal bodies, and the fifth one is cell junction, gap junction and type junction. In subunit 3.2, you have to study histology. It deals with the histological structure and function of the following organs of mammals. First is pituitary gland, second is thyroid gland, third is adrenal gland, fourth is ovary and testes, and fifth is kidney. In unit 4, you have to study about animal behavior and economic zoology. 4.1 social behavior, subunit 4.1 is about social behavior of honeybee and termite. 4.2 subunit is courtship and reproductive behavior of spiders, scorpion and peacock. 4.3 is parental care behavior, aerius, ichthyophis and elitis. 4.4 is household insects, insect affecting human health. First is housefly, second is mosquito. Second is insect that damaging food products. First is rice weevil, second is wheat weevil. Third is insect damaging household goods. First is termite, second is silverfish. Insect damaging storage crane. First is Tribolium, second is pulse petal. And in unit 5, wildlife biology, ecology and instrumental biology, there are further 5-6 subunits. First subunit is wildlife in India and its conservation. Second is reasons for depletion of wildlife in India. 5.3, the third subunit is wildlife in Gujarat. There are two national parks you have to study, Vansanda National Park and Vairavadar National Park, and also two sanctuaries like Ratan Mahal Sloth Bear Sanctuary and Sul Parneshwar Wildlife Sanctuary you have to study it. In fourth subunit, threatened wild animals of India, in mammals, slender lorries, black nilgiri, langur, cheetah, Asiatic lion, tiger and snow leopard. Second is birds, pink-headed duck, Himalayan golden eagle, पिकॉक, ग्रेट इंडियन बास्टार्ड, ग्रेटर फ्लेमिंगो, वल्चर, लॉन्ग बिल्ड किरनारी कीट इज द थ्रेटन्ड वाइल्ड एनिमल्स ऑफ इंडिया दैट वी हैव टू स्टडी इन 5.5. इकोलॉजी इज स्टडिंग एनर्जी फ्लो इन इकोसिस्टम एंड इकोलॉजिकल पिरामिड्स एंड इन 5.6 सब यूनिट इंस्ट्रूमेंटल बायोलॉजी वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट फेज कॉन्ट्रास्ट माइक्रोस्कोप, हीमोग्लोबिनोमीटर एंड स्फिग्मोमीटर, स्फिग्मोमैनोमीटर. In here, we are studying about the principle of this instrument and the application in various fields we are studying. Here we are discussing about your syllabus that you will learn into this semester. Thank you for listening to me. Any questions? And here I have one homework for you. What is systematics? In further session, we are learn about what is systematics. We are start our first unit, systematics. Thank you.